There she is, the daily driver. Not a garage queen at all. So, good morning, everybody. Wow, I just gotta say, like, that the reaction to that video, I mean, I kind of knew the title was good, but I didn't think it was like gonna be that good. Just wow. Thank you, everybody who commented. Thank you to everybody who had something nice to say. Pretty exciting to see when I woke up this morning, like 50 plus emails in my inbox of just all like YouTube comments, man. I've never had a reaction to any of my videos like that, you know. You know, I'm new to all this, and you know, I would love to be a real like YouTuber one day. It's funny because, you know, most of the YouTubers that I watch or that I enjoy is like guys just like this, like, you know, just, I used to think that YouTube had to be this, you know, big production every time you made a video, or like, you know, like this big, like, you know, with a intro and, you know, like all these funny edits and all this other shit. And I think like the most enjoyable stuff is like just, you know, having good conversation with people that you have like a similar mindset with, or, you know, similar views. Like some of my favorite YouTubers are like Sam Sulek, or, you know, like everybody likes to like listen to like Joe Rogan, you know, or like I like Alex Flores, you know, just to name a few. Like there's a ton that I don't understand why they have the fame that they have, but I'm not going to name any names because I'm not a hater. But like, you know, just some of these guys that, you know, that they have no idea what the fuck they're talking about. But anyway, back to the topic. So like part two of my other video, it's like all the hate, right? So like even in the comments of this video, it's amazing to me some of the shit that people say. Like there's guys in the video, I just got a comment right now. The guy was like, oh, millionaire's bad day. Bro, do I look like a millionaire? I was up at fucking 5 o'clock this morning on a Saturday to come to work while most of you motherfuckers are on your fourth dream. I made that video, I was sitting in my car on my fucking break. You know, my hands were dirty. If you look close enough, my hands were fucking dirty. But whatever, it's just, it goes back to what I was saying about people assuming or thinking that they know, you know, something about someone just based off a fucking vehicle that they drive. And it just so happens to be that vehicle, like, is a Tesla, and automatically people just assume. And like, yeah, there was a point where Teslas were super expensive. I remember when they first came out, I thought it was so cool. I was like, fuck, but that, you know, that 100 plus K car was like way too much money. But I mean, if you think about it nowadays, all the nice cars cost a fucking 100K. Like a fucking pickup truck is $90,000. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's crazy. We live in a fucked up time. I'm glad that I grew up, you know, I'm one of the last generation that's probably seen it all. Like from playing outside to, you know, not even having a cell phone. I had a pager, you know, all that kind of shit. It's crazy. It's crazy. Crazy. But there was another comment in there. Well, what was the fucking guy saying? He was saying I was an influencer. Man, I wish I was a fucking influencer. There's some kid in there talking about his GTI. Why is it always the guy that says, you know, oh, fuck, Teslas are junk or this and this and that. And it's like a guy who drives like a fucking GTI or a fucking Honda. Man, shut the fuck up. What do you know? I told the kid I had a GTI when I was fucking 17 years old, man. You know? So it's always that guy. Like, you shut up. Don't comment on shit you shouldn't be commenting on. And then, like, so you watch these racing videos. There's a lot of channels that are, like, race channels that I love to watch. And they're all, like, biased, right? They'll post a video of, like, you know, a Plaid, let's say, racing, whatever. Like, it's always a Plaid, right? It's always a Plaid. Sometimes it's not a Plaid, but they say it's a Plaid anyway. But they'll post a Plaid, like, losing to whatever, and it's always some fucking fucked up circumstance, or or like the car is just flat out faster. I mean, like a Plaid is not unbeatable, right? Like you put a Plaid against like, you know, a highly modified Porsche, you know, with upgraded turbos, especially the 992s, which are fast as fuck. You know, like, yeah, it's going to lose, especially over 160 miles per hour. You know, we all know the Plaid is limited to 163 or 164 in Plaid mode. And nobody races in track mode because, you know, for some reason, the car's not the same. It doesn't have the same acceleration in track mode. So now when you get a video that it's like the Plaid beats the other car, everybody's like, Oh, well, I'll drive the other car any day of the week or this and that. It's like, bro, who are you? Like, why do we care what you drive? You know, it's crazy, man. What's some of the other common shit is like, you know, all these videos you'll see like on Twitter. I like to look on Twitter. Twitter's nuts, by the way. Like Twitter has, or X rather, it's like completely unfiltered. You see some of the craziest shit on there, but on there, like you'll just see these videos, all these Sentry Cam videos, even on YouTube, you see them of like, people just randomly vandalizing a Tesla or unplugging it or whatever. And it's just like, I could never be that bothered by what someone else is doing to just go out of my way to be a fucking dickhead. Like you gotta be a real special kind of fucking jerk off to just go and unplug somebody's car or scratch somebody's car or whatever. Like I get it. Like people are like anti, you know, they think it's like the government's forcing them down their throat or this and that and whatever. I mean, but phone away then. Throw your phone away. Throw Alexa away, because all that shit is the same thing. You know, I'm not going to get into any conspiracy theory or none of that, but just think about it. Like, you sound dumb. And it's like, you still have the choice. Like, you know, until it's truly forced, then, you know, some of the other stuff is like the whole charging thing, right? So, like, people are like, oh, you know, like, I like to drive a lot. Like, man, how much do you fucking drive? Like, do you get in your car and go to California from New York every day? Like, what are you talking about? Like, how often do you really get in your car and take a long trip? And if you do, like, you got to stop and piss anyway. You still got to stop and whatever. Like, yeah, it's going to add a little time to your trip. So what? You're saving a fuck ton of money on fuel. So pick and choose your battles. Like, people are just... All the cars in Chicago that got caught in the snow or you know, the cold weather. I mean, that's the problem with that, is like a lot of people, they don't have the proper charging situation for their car. Like a lot of people, even here, like too many people rely on the supercharger network, which I disagree with. I think that if you buy electric car, you should have a charging solution, you know, at your house or at your job. And, you know, a supercharger should just be for, you know, when you need it, whenever it's necessary. I've only used it, supercharger, maybe 3 times in the past year and a half that I've had Tesla. Or year and change, whatever. And that's only when I've gone, like, on a long trip and, you know, I had to just, you know, charge up or top off. The longest trip I took in the Plaid was I went down to Maryland for Memorial Day weekend. And I went down to Maryland. I charged the car to 100%. Left from my house to Maryland. I got there with 30%. I pulled right into a charging garage that had Tesla superchargers in the garage. Plugged my car. Went to go eat. Did whatever we were doing. By the time I was done eating, my car was fully charged up, and we drove back home. I mean, it was like not inconvenient at all. So I'm finishing this video up. Another day. Couldn't finish recording the other day, but I want to just kind of fall back on what I was talking about. Basically, that, you know, the fuck the haters, man. Like, these Tesla haters are no different than, you know, any other kind of hater, right? It's just people are just fucking jealous at the end of the day. Or they just, you know, people fear what they don't understand, or hate, you know, hate what they can't conquer, right? It's like with Nas. You know, the electric cars are the new technology, and you can't beat, you know, the instant torque, the torque vectoring for the, you know, the traction control, and you know, the power delivery, right? So something like a Plaid with 1,000 horsepower, 1,000 foot-pounds of torque, that it doesn't fall off. Like everybody says that Teslas are quick, not fast. You know, a Plaid is fast. It's fast. I mean, if you're trapping 150 plus miles per hour in the quarter mile, your shit is fast. With the unlock, you know, your top end is not limited at all. This car will just keep pulling. So, you know, going back to what I was talking about in, you know, like some of the racing videos or some comments are, you know, I'd rather grill my steak than eat it in a microwave, or, you know, Teslas are gay. You know, you say that people say something's gay when they don't have a fucking argument for it. You know, they don't have a valid, legitimate reason to hate on it or be mad at it. So just say, oh, it's gay. You know, the built not bought guys are always crying, you know, like, oh, you know, you didn't have to do anything to it. Yeah, no shit. Like, that's the point. You buy something like this, you don't want to fucking do anything to it.
That's it. You know, I can modify my car to beat a Plaid, but your Plaid is stuck where it's at. Okay, cool. Like, if you can beat a Plaid, you can go faster than a 9.2. Or you know, a 4.6, 4.7, 60 to 130. Kudos to you, my man. Like, we don't care. Like, I want to speak. I'm going to speak in general for almost all Plaid owners. We don't care. You know, the idea behind this car is, like, you buy it and you don't have to worry about it. You don't have to do anything to it. You don't want to do anything to it. You know, dealing with tuners is annoying. Dealing with shops is annoying. Everybody knows this shit. Like, this is common nowadays. It's hard to find a good, legitimate shop. It's hard to find a good tuner. And if the tuner's good, it's hard to get a hold of them. You know? Doing the data logs and all that stuff back and forth, it's a pain in the ass. You know? And just all that, you know? Like, I don't want to harp on this shit too much. But it's just like now. Like, you know, I'm a longshoreman, right? We're on strike. And, you know, I've been dealing with, like, a lot of hateful comments and ignorant comments, you know, and it just comes down to jealousy, man. We live in a day and age where people are, you know, look at everything with an envious eye or whatever the case may be, and, you know, you can't control it, you can't. So, I've gotten some really good comments, some really good supportive comments, and, you know, some fellow Plaid owners and, you know, soon-to-be Plaid owners or Tesla owners. And it's true, man. You know, just live life. You know, fuck them. Fuck the haters, you know. My next video, I want to talk about why I feel like the Plaid is a better platform versus the G80, the G80 M3. I'm going to compare the two. I had both, so, you know, nobody can talk shit. I had both, so. That's going to be coming up next. I'm going to try to keep, you know, at least do one video a week. I really want to keep this channel going. I hope that, you know, I didn't rant too much in this video or, you know, sound like I'm talking in circles. But, you know, I'm enjoying having these conversations with you guys, and it seems like, you know, the love is there. So I'm going to keep them pumping, and, you know, I hope you guys enjoy. Peace.